Welcome back, everybody. My name is All Fun and Games. I stream every day on Twitch TV, and I also make fun little videos here on YouTube. Today, I'm going to be showcasing a fun little thing that you might not have actually known about, depending on if you've played with people in the server before. If you played solo, you probably would never have done this before. But if you have been playing with friends and they've been asking you countless amounts of times, hey, I really want to get your map as you have more than I do. How do I do that? What do I do? Well, let's showcase what you need. Okay, so let's just imagine that you press M and you've revealed everything that there is to reveal about your map. Now your friend joins in and goes, hey, what's up? Well, you probably want to set them up with the same map exploration that you have so they don't have to spend time exploring. However, let's talk about what you need. Of course, I'm in creative mode, as I always am when I'm doing these guides, and you need a cartographer's desk, which of course requires a compass and four boards, which are pretty much easy to get. Of course, go through the process of getting a science machine and an alchemy machine first, and then worry about this after, as it's not necessary to do this right away, because by the time you need to reveal your entire map, it'll probably be pretty late game. So, pretty much what you do from there is you make said desk, and then you need a few ingredients in order to do so further than that, and you need to make a map scroll. For that, you need papyrus, which requires pretty much nothing at all except some generic reeds that you can get from going into the swamplands and basically picking them with your hands. Once you have the reeds, turn them into one piece of paper, and then get yourself a feather pencil. How to get yourself a feather pencil, which is also used in our previous video, which I showcased how to actually label some chests. You get yourself a feather from a crow, the jet feather specifically, one charcoal, and one twig. The easiest recipe in the world. Honestly, it doesn't take very long to get that. If you've watched my video on how to basically make boomerangs, you can get a ton of crows really easily, or you can just catch them using traps or whatever you might have to do. But nonetheless, it's very simple to kill a crow and get a crow. Like I said, boomerangs are the best, especially if you're playing somebody like Wartox. You can get tons of souls in a few minutes. Then, by hovering near your cartographer's desk, I will go out of creative mode so you can kind of see what you need to make. You will find, or if you can type the word map scroll, you can go into here and you'll see that it requires one pencil and one papyrus, and it'll make yourself a map. Basically, what happens is as soon as this is made, it's essentially a blueprint of your map. So, of course, if I read it, it's not going to do anything because I already revealed the whole thing. But if I pass it off to somebody else, they're going to now see everything that I have revealed on my map. Now, as soon as you make this is when it imprints all that data onto the scroll. So, for example, if you decide that you want to make this right away and then hand it to somebody after, well, you got to make sure that you're making this after you've revealed most of the map. That's why I said don't worry about making the actual desk first, because you're probably going to want to explore quite a bit of the world first. So save it for like day 25 or pretty much anything that you want to actually have it. And you can do the same in the caves, by the way, too. So keep that in mind. But anyways, all they got to do is right click on it and learn it. But of course, for me, I already have the map completely revealed, so it's not really doing any changes for me. And voila, now you have everything else revealed. If you're playing another player, of course, I don't have anybody in the server with me. Otherwise, I'd have them do a thumbs up emoji, which you can't actually do, but you get the idea of it. Anyways, that's how you have somebody else reveal and share the map between two players. Thanks again for watching. I'll catch you in the next one.